I think that the bottom line for this is maybe one of the ways, be it war or a pandemic, it takes us back to what we do with our suffering, both individually and with all of us. What do we do with the feelings of unease, the tension, the stressors? And that is something in mental health that we often have to, both ourselves and the folks who we work with, how do we find a way to do something that can grow us? Right. How do we do something that we can think and feel with the things that are happening to us? And right. People don't realize this, but there's a difference between an experience and a feeling. There's a difference between, because we go back to that notion of automaticity. Often the things that we are experiencing, we don't actually, they don't become feelings in the truest sense. They don't become something that we can name, that we can do something with. They usually just trigger that automatic response. And so much of the work that we do is at least initially opening the possibility of something in between this nascent experience and then the action that occurs, something that's there in the middle. And that's kind of what therapy does. Someone steps into an office and they tell you a story, often about what happened the week before or the day before or that day. And as they speak it, they're slowly but surely you've created a space where they can start to put that into words. And sometimes your goal and your role, right, is to be able to, as you help them put that into words, to be able to make connections with it. Mm-hmm. They are dancing with their suffering and you're helping them. And then at some point at the end of this, they might be able to have not only named, which is sometimes enough to be mm-hmm. able to name and contain, but mm-hmm. to also potentially do something with it.
Right.